It's a beautiful day to be alive. Now lockdown has got over in a lot of places. The salons and the beauty parlors may not have opened. And even if they have, I won't recommend you to go and get those services done. Even though their staffs might be practicing all the hygiene methods, still, it's sort of scary. And the last time I got my eyebrows threaded was in the starting of March, which is near about 4 months now. And they were in a very bad shape. And those salons have opened in my area. I'm just scared to go and get them threaded because the person is going to hold the thread in their mouth while do your eyebrows, and the thought even scares me. So I thought of doing my eyebrows at home and also show the process to you so that if you want to get your eyebrows done, you can do it yourself. For this method, there are a few things which you need. You need an eyebrow pencil, a small pair of eyebrow scissors, tweezers, and an eyebrow razor. I'll leave the online links to buy all of these things in the bottom description bar. Most of these online shopping portals have now resumed their services, so you can order them to your home and do your own eyebrows. So let's start this process. Now first of all, I'm going to use an eyebrow pencil to fill in my eyebrows and also mark the shape which I want my eyebrows to be. This eyebrow pencil is from Shop Miss A and you can use any one you like. I'm filling in my eyebrows a little too heavy so that it looks a little darker and it's easier for me to shape them. Now I'm going to repeat the same thing on my other eyebrow. Now this is the shape which I want my eyebrows to be, and I'm going to remove all of the hair that is outside these marked spaces. First I'll use the small scissor and I'm going to trim the length of the hair over here. This is similar to what your parlor lady does after threading your eyebrows. I'm keeping the blade of the scissor in the upper line of my eyebrow and then I just cut it so that the extra length is cut. Sometimes I skip this step if I want a more feathery look. Now let's do the same thing on my other eyebrow. Next I'm going to use this pair of tweezers and mine is a bit angular at the tip, so that makes it easier for me to hold each and every hair strand. And using this tweezer, I'm just going to pluck out all of the hairs which are a little bit thicker, and I'm doing it outside the border of the eyebrows which I have drawn. Trust me, this is way less painful than what you do in the parlor. To pluck the hair from the center area and above my eyebrows, I'm just doing it lightly, but when I have to do it under my eyebrows, I'm just using my finger to lift it a little so that the skin is stretched and it's easier for me to pluck it. Now I have removed all of the bigger and thicker hairs using the plucker. For the smaller hairs, I have two options. First one is using this Veet Sensitive Touch Electric Trimmer. Now I have already made a complete review and demo sort of video of this, so I'll provide the link to that video here in the I button. And in this video, I'll show you the other method, which is using one of these eyebrow razors. Now if I have to compare between both of these, I'll prefer this one because this gives a cleaner look as it cuts the hair from the skin, but this leaves a very small gap, so if you look a little more closely, you can see the hairs, and also the results of this lasts longer. If you're a beginner and you're not confident enough of using a razor and you're scared that you may cut your skin, I would advise you to go for this trimmer. And once you have got hang of how to use it, you can switch over to this razor. So now I'm going to use this razor and I'll remove all of the hair that is outside the boundary which I have drawn. Let's start with the center part, and I'm going to keep the blade on the line of this eyebrow and I'll just pull it outside. I'll do the same thing on the other eyebrow. So all of the hair from the middle part has gone. Now let's do the upper area. If you feel like you can keep it here and remove it in the upward direction, but I get more control when I do it downwards. So I'm just gonna pull the blade until the border of my eyebrows. It's easier if you pull the skin and keep it firm. Now let's do the same thing on my other eyebrow. Now I'm going to remove the hair on the bottom area of my eyebrows. I find it a little more challenging over here where I have the curve, but with practice it gets easier. I'm going to pull my skin very tightly and remove it. Now if you're not sure, leave it a little more thicker because it's easy to make your eyebrows thinner, but once you remove a little too much of hair, there's no going back. Now using the same razor, I'm going to remove the hair from my upper lips, sideburns, and all of the baby hairs on my forehead. For my upper lip area, I just keep my tongue over here and stretch my skin, and then I just remove the hair. For my sideburns area, I just pull all of my hairs to the top using my finger and then stretch my cheeks and remove the hair. On my forehead, I just pull all of the hairs on my hairline, and using this razor, I just cut all the hair off. And I always tie my hair in a tight ponytail before I remove all of my facial hair, so it makes all of the things easier for me. Alright, now I have removed all of the unwanted hair from my face. I'll just wipe my face using micellar water, and I'm using this Pond's Vitamin Micellar Water. This is in the variant Hydrating Aloe Vera, and I'm using this one because aloe vera is supposed to be good for sensitive skin, and it works as a great aftershave. And after applying this micellar water, I usually use aloe vera gel on my face so that in case there are some minor cuts, it's going to get healed. And this is how my eyebrows look now, so much better than before. I have applied a little bit of makeup, I have filled in my eyebrows. Now doing this doesn't give you that sharp shape which you get after threading in a salon. It's more like a natural sort of brow look, and I actually like it better. I have been doing my eyebrows since a very long time at home. I just get them threaded before any event, which is like about 2 times a year, and the rest of the time I do it at home because I have really sensitive skin, and when I get them threaded, this whole area becomes red and I get some bumps over there, and it's so painful, and that's basically the reason I like doing them myself at home. Now some of you may wonder about using the razor on your face. In case you are scared, let me tell you, no, the hair doesn't get thicker. You're not going to get beard like a man. I've been doing this since years. I only thread my eyebrows. I have never done waxing or threading on this area of my face, and no, my hair hasn't become any thicker. In fact, I actually like shaving my face. It gives a very smooth sort of texture. My makeup applies so much better after I do it, and it's like you're exfoliating the outer layer of your skin, so all the skincare products you're going to apply after that, your skin is going to absorb them better. So shaving is good for your skin, and the hair removal process is not painful. So yeah, that's how you can remove all the unwanted hair from your face at home. I hope this video was helpful for you. If it was, do like on this video, subscribe to my channel, and also share this video with your friends, because that is going to help me grow, and also it will motivate me to take my work forward and make more such videos for you all. That's all for this video. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.